This is not your usual racing circuit. It provides one of the most complete tests for the field. Sector 1 sports a set of 90-degree corners around the block, if you like. Sector 2 gets even tighter with the old city walls. Sector 3, just turn 16 to negotiate, and then 2.2 kilometers, flat to the floor, full throttle, in sixth gear, all the way to the end. Here are the starting positions for today's race. A fantastic effort from Guan Yu Zhou yesterday puts him on pole position, with Yuri Vips starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Aitken, Lundgaard, Marcus Armstrong, and Lawson. Sato, Vachon, Tictum, Bent Fiskal, Zendeli, Porcher, Guillaume Somaya, Fittipaldi, Piastri, Nissani, Drugovic, and Jayant Dhruvala. Beckman, Boschon, Deledda, and a Prema rounds off the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. Joining me today is a man who is no stranger to going fast, Davide Valsecchi of GP2 2012 fame. Great to have you here today, Davide. Are you enjoying yourself here in the beautiful city of Baku?
Absolutely, Alex. Baku is fantastic. And so this track, have a check. The architecture, the narrow street, easy to see why it's one of the most exciting circuits on the calendar. But Alex, street circuits can be unforgiving. I wouldn't be surprised if you see a safety car or two out during today's race.
Okay, good work. Great pass. moved into P2. That's P2 now.
our winner pulling their Prema into Parc Fermé then. What a fantastic race. So, Davide, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, I'm not sure what we just saw, but one thing's for sure. Today's winner has certainly showed they have no fear battling it out on the track. And who can blame them? I don't think I ever seen someone in through the competition so quickly. Today's race was a sight to behold, and judging from the crowd's reaction, it went down well with the fans as well.
As we look back on a thrilling race here today, we can now see the drivers take their places on the podium. It's a familiar sight by now, as it's another successful F2 win for Prema.